The Prophet Muhammad said that a time would come when the whole world would gather around to plan the destruction of the Muslims, as if they were gathered around a table to take part in a meal. Today, the nations of the world are doing just that, around the circular tables of the United Nations General Assembly Hall. He also said that the time of the Dajjal will be years of confusion. People will believe a liar and disbelieve one who is trustworthy, and those who rebel against God will have a say in general affair. Today, during the time preceding the Dajjal, there is also a time of confusion. The system set up by the forerunners to the Dajjal have ensnared many Muslims away from truth. Using lures such as wealth and materialism and fulfillment of earthly desires. A miserable trade indeed. These times of tribulation are like a giant sieve, sorting out the true believers from the apostates and hypocrites. Many have adopted the lifestyle and philosophy of the Dajjal system, retaining perhaps only their Muslim names or clothing, wearing them like a badge to their identity, and in every other way embracing wholeheartedly the system that is being used to eradicate Islam. Embracing the same system that stood back and did nothing when pregnant Muslim women had their bellies ripped open by Serbs, killing them and the contents of their wombs. The same system that stands still whilst women and small girls are being raped in Kashmir. A system that stood still whilst mothers saw their children dragged away by soldiers during the night, never to return, simply because they spoke out against being refugees in their own homeland. And the same system that said nothing to the tyrant that gassed women and children simply because he danced the Masonic tune. For those who choose this system, claim to love Allah and his messenger, but hate what he has brought, leave the guidance that is Islam, and they adhere to the evil system of the Dajjal, living their lives in accordance with its rules and seeking from it worldly rewards, disregarding the truth that is the laws of Allah. They are those who invite upon themselves the wrath of Allah. The forerunners to the Dajjal have set up this system to destroy Islam, either directly, through military and economic coercion, or indirectly, using ideological warfare. They have divided and conquered, instilling diseases such as nationalism and racism into the heart of the Ummah. Their biggest fear is Muslim unity and revival of the message brought by the last prophet to mankind. And everything they do is geared to prevent this. They have manipulated Muslims, setting up and promoting divides. They have installed their own universal language, compelling all to learn or be shut out. And what they have used most to keep the Muslims at bay is oil. During World War I, the Freemasonic governments managed to destroy the Islamic Caliphate and annex all its territories. The part now called Iraq was put to British mandate. After its independence, the USA took over interest in Iraq. In fear of a purist Islamic uprising, the CIA aided the Ba'ath Party's rise to power, making Saddam Hussein the leader of Iraq and an ally to the Masonic states. When Kuwait later started raising its oil prices, it was destroying the war-torn economy of Iraq. Threats were made but ignored. The situation worsened until finally Iraqi troops were mobilized to the border. The Freemasonic media, the American media in particular, portrayed this as a shock and outrage. However, it is reported that the US ambassador to Kuwait had prior knowledge of the invasion and Iraq's intentions, as did the CIA. After the Gulf War, Saddam is still alive, and Kuwait has been liberated. It remains to be asked exactly what purpose the Gulf War served to its Freemasonic orchestrators. The Masonic West has long realized that the control of oil is vital to their economies. One of the main reasons is their reliance on cars and road transport. However, although technology exists to mass produce fully operational electric cars, all attempts to do so have been vetoed. This is because oil is crucial to maintaining their world order. And without the puppet governments and leaders, such as Saddam Hussein, the Freemasonic West could not control the Muslim nations. Without the division of wealth and false leadership of these nations, nothing would prevent the purest Islamic movements from coming to power. Poverty creates unity, and Muslim unity is the greatest fear of the forerunners to the Dajjal. The Gulf Wars serve many purposes: to promote Western unity, to create divides amongst the Muslim nations, to act as a testing ground for an entire arsenal of military weapons and cocktails of chemicals and drugs. But most of all, it served to ensure a strong military presence in the Middle East. The Dajjal has placed a strong hold in the very heart of Islam itself and laid a firm grip on the Muslim holy lands.